For the majority of our remote learning, we're setting lessons on a weekly basis on our virtual learning environment. The tasks usually involve something along the lines of watching a video or reading some pages from BBC Bite Size or from the student's revision guide, followed by some form of activity that the students can then self-mark themselves against pre-prepared answers. Once these activities are completed, there is then always some form of formal assessment that the students submit for teacher feedback, and this also allows us to check for completion of the work set. However, there are some activities where I feel that the students would benefit from some teacher explanation. And this might be topics that I know are particularly tricky, and so where I feel that the students would benefit from seeing the process modelled. Or it might be where I know that the students have specific misconceptions that I'd like to address head on. Now, for this form of live teaching, there's lots of different options available to you. It might be that you've got software that enables you to annotate on your tablets, or perhaps you've got a visualizer at home or have mocked one up using your mobile phone. However, the process that I found the best is to put together a PowerPoint show, and this is for several reasons. Firstly, it uses software that I'm familiar with, so I'm instantly more relaxed when putting together the presentation and I'm able to focus on the teaching as opposed to the technology. The next thing, because I don't want the PowerPoint shows to be too long, it forces me to think about how to break perhaps a bigger topic down into smaller bite-sized chunks that won't overload the students. Once I've decided on the subtopic that I'm going to put together the show on, the next thing is that by putting together the PowerPoint slides in advance, it forces me to think about the sequencing of my teaching and ensuring that there's a real clarity in the explanation. There's no room for backtrack or for waffling. And then the final thing that I've found useful with the PowerPoint shows is that I'm able to put simple questions into the PowerPoint show and encourage the students to pause the video, write down the answers, and then restart the video before checking them against the answers provided. And if the students haven't got those answers correct, they've always got the ability to rewind and go back and look at the explanation again before moving on to the next section of the PowerPoint. Practically, it's very easy to put together the PowerPoint show. Initially, it's simply a matter of putting together an animated presentation with the animations controlled by mouse clicks. Once you've got the learning sequence sorted, it's worth going through and thinking about what you might say at each stage in the explanation. However, this is very much controlled by the PowerPoint show and doesn't need to be scripted. I also like to think at this point about where I'd like the students' attention to be directed. Perhaps is the text animated as I read through a key definition, or is text that is no longer referred to just dimmed out so it doesn't distract the students' attention. Finally, it's also worth thinking about how much information you put on each slide. Obviously, you want to avoid cognitive overload, so keep it to a minimum. And also bear in mind that the students might be looking at these presentations on relatively small mobile phone screens, and so the text has to be quite big so that they can see it. To record the slideshow, it's simply a matter of clicking on slideshow, record slideshow, and then you can choose to either record the show slide by slide or in a whole go. The top tip, if you choose to record it in a single go, make sure that you leave a pause between slides to allow time for the slide transition. Once you've recorded the animation and the narration appears as a separate audio file on each slide, which enables you to delete any where you've spotted any errors. If you wish, you can also turn on the webcam and have the students have a visual view of you as you go through each of the slides in the presentation. Once you're happy with your presentation, I usually save it as a PowerPoint show, as this avoids any chance of corruption between different versions of PowerPoint, in a similar way to saving a Word document as a PDF. The PowerPoint shows are usually quite large at this point, so it's important to think about how you're going to share them with your students, but there's lots of file sharing platforms available that can be used to do this, or simply they can be uploaded directly onto your virtual learning environment. So I hope you found this short video useful. Have a look at the example that I put together for my Year 12 class on the energetics topic, and simply have a play and give it a go.